this small but mighty lander that Pittsburgh company Astrobotic named the Peregrine will have the attention of the world Monday morning. At 2:18 a.m., it is scheduled to be launched into space on a United Launch Alliance Vulcan rocket from Cape Canaveral, Florida, with its GPS set for the moon.
As you might imagine, we had a lot of people that didn't believe us along the way, that a small startup in Pittsburgh, of all places, could build a space company, much less a moon company that can make money. We did just that.
John Thornton is CEO of Astrobotic, headquartered on Pittsburgh's north side. Some of the world's most cutting-edge science is happening behind these walls. It's not Silicon Valley. It's not New York or Los Angeles. It's North Lincoln Avenue on the north side.
And I think this is Pittsburgh at its best. This is 16 years of hard work. We don't have a billionaire backing us. We don't even have major backers at all. We've just been building this up ourselves. And that's a very Pittsburgh way to do things.
The unmanned mission will go like this. After launch Monday morning, the Vulcan rocket will place Peregrine on a lunar trajectory outside the Earth's atmosphere. Then it will separate from its upper stage, called the Centaur 5. Using its own engines, it will continue to orbit the moon several times, which will last several weeks, before hopefully touching down softly on the moon's surface at a location chosen by NASA called the Grünheisen Domes on February 23rd. The timing of everything coincides with lunar dawn. The sunrise on the moon only comes once every 28 days. Thornton says by the time they land, they'll have about 10 days left of light to get work done before total darkness.
We have about 20 payloads that are coming with us, a mix of science instruments. We've got rovers. We even have a rover from Carnegie Mellon. And they'll drop and deploy and all proceed to do their missions as quickly as they can before the sun sets in just 10 days. So it will be a flurry of activity.
This is a one-way ticket. Those instruments will send back data and video of what they collect, but they aren't coming back. Astrobotic won a contract from NASA as part of their Commercial Lunar Payload Services, or CLPS, initiative and Artemis program. On this lander, there are research materials from six countries, all of it assembled in this room on the north side.
They just realized this is like that first really big step towards making the moon so much more accessible.
John Kersting is with the Pittsburgh Tech Council. They've been connecting those in the tech sector for 41 years. He says this may be one of the biggest accomplishments ever made by one of their affiliates.
I mean, this is something that I think, whether you're into technology or not, this is going in the history books that something's going to go to the moon. Like, and our fingers are crossed, and we're praying for, and we're pretty confident they'll have a nice soft landing.
Right.
And this will be the start of a whole new industry really starting to bloom by the fact that you can get to the moon a lot easier now through Pittsburgh. So, yeah, it's cool.
We caught a glimpse of the future watching the future at the Moonshot Museum in Pittsburgh. The museum shares a wall with Astrobotic, part of it glass, which has allowed Pittsburghers to watch the Peregrine being built for years now.
Is it surprising that something that's going to the moon was made like 50 feet from where we're standing?
Yeah, I was incredibly surprised about that. Like, there's already a rover in that room, literally right over there.
This visit, enough to change Bryce's life dreams.
I'm being an astronaut, I can tell you that right now.
One of the other really cool features of this mission, you won't be hearing anything about Houston.
That's right. It's no longer Houston. It is Mission Control Pittsburgh.
From about an hour after launch on Monday through the entirety of the mission on the moon, everything will be controlled from the Mission Control Center at Astrobotic on the north side.
It is a mix of excitement, feeling of accomplishment to get to this point, but we're also all terrified. There's a lot on the line, and we've done everything we can to increase our odds of success. But at the end of the day, we are up against the hardest environment known to man, and we'll be braving the elements and going at it. So we're very, very excited. It's edge of our seats.
And you know I had to ask, are they sending a terrible Tau to the moon? Well, Jonathan Thornton, the CEO there, told me they had a contest to determine what piece of Pittsburgh memorabilia should go. And the winner was a token from Kennywood going to the moon. You can see live coverage of Monday's launch on NASA Plus, NASA Television, or the NASA app. Astrobotic also has another lander that's set to go to the moon near the end of this year for a separate mission. We are wishing them the absolute best.